Psalm 24. Alleluia. 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 The earth belongs to the Lord, and everything on it is the Lord's. For God founded it in empty space and breathed the divine life breath into it, filling it with manifold creatures, each one precious in God's sight. Alleluia. Alleluia. Who is fit to hold power and worthy to act in God's place? Those with a passion for the truth. Alleluia. Alleluia. Those who are horrified by injustice, who act with mercy to the poor, and take up the cause of the helpless. Alleluia. Alleluia. Those who have let go of selfish concerns and see the whole earth as sacred, refusing to exploit her creatures or to foul her waters and lands. Alleluia. Alleluia. Their strength is in their compassion. God's light shines through their hearts. Their children's children will bless them, and the work of their hands will endure. Alleluia.
Sandy.
A reading from Father Francis Bauer. As spiritual persons, we are finally described as the people of the good news. The news must be good, first of all, to those who hear it. Otherwise, it cannot enhance their lives. Our first good news is surely not what we say, what we preach, what we proclaim in our demonstrations. Our first good news is ourselves. In a very real sense, we cannot speak the good news. We can merely show it forth. And it will be shown in the quality of our own lives, in the passion we bring to one another, in the joy we show in shared presence, in the love we offer to those least likely. It is the intent of our prayerful and liturgical celebrations to enflesh us with the good news, to fashion us by participation into the living symbol of what God can do, to draw us into godliness by tasting the bread which is the source of all life. Only when the conviction of our own worth and our own goodness breaks into celebration will the convictions of our faith grab hold of us with awesome power, so that our very presence to others will be good news indeed. If we are enamored of life, it will show in everything we do, everything we say. It will show in our attitudes, in our values, in our relationships, and most of all, in our love. Only when others first respond to our presence will they ask us who we are, and then we, the people of the good news, will begin to tell our stories and show to others that it is possible to say, "Our Father."
Thank you.
Our prayers tonight are from David Adam. Grant us a vision, Lord, to see what we can achieve, to reach out beyond ourselves. Grant us a vision, Lord, to share our lives with others, to stretch our capabilities. Grant us a vision, Lord, to increase our sense of purpose, to be aware of where we can help. Grant us a vision, Lord, to be sensitive to your presence, to give heed to your constant call.
The Lord's Prayer from the New Zealand Prayer Book. Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and that shall be, Father and Mother of us all, loving God, in whom is heaven, the hallowing of your name echo through the universe. The way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. Your heavenly will be done by all created beings. Your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and come on earth. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. In times of temptation and test, strengthen us. From trials too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Amen.
Come and fill our hearts with your peace, your love, Lord.
Our closing meditation is from Howard Thurman. When the song of angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when kings and princes are home, when shepherds are back with their flock, the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among people, to make music in the heart.
Thank you.